Hi there, Eric Bakker, naturopath from New Zealand, coming back to you again with Mast Cell Activation Syndrome. We're talking about problems there with inappropriate, response of white blood cells in the body. So what we're going to look really is at some of the causes of this problem. Well, a lot of people now believe that genetics do play a major role in causing this condition. There was a study conducted in 2013 that showed that over 70% of people with mast cell problems, in fact, they've got a blood relative also with a mast cell problem. So it could be a little bit like eczema or asthma. Often there'll be some type of relative involved here that's passed that gene down to you. So, but then again, there are a lot of people who develop mast cell problems who never have relatives with this issue at all. So what could some of the likely causes be there? Apart from causes, are there any triggers for this condition? Because triggers and causes are not dislike. So if we look at some of the triggers typically for people, in my opinion, it'll be digestive problems and stress underpinning a lot of this. Inappropriate eating, leaky gut, the development of parasites or poor bacterial load in the gut, the development of too much yeast building up in the gut. All these things create massive immune dysfunction, and they almost enforce that the immune system has to shadow box all these things constantly in the gut to keep on top of things. So the gut is often the seat of inflammation for many people. This to me is one of the prime causes in my mind of not just mast cell problem, but many, many different diseases that people develop as they get older, is digestive imbalance. We see this particularly with autoimmune disorders. I've not met an autoimmune patient yet who's got an outstanding digestive health. Every single one I've seen over the years has got some kind of a gut dysfunction that needs correcting, which makes me wonder if the gut problem helped to contribute to the autoimmune problem. In some of my earlier videos, if you've watched enough of my videos, I've spoken that I like old medical textbooks. And in particular, a 1930s textbook from the British Medical Journal book I was reading in a long time ago, it said that in all cases of autoimmune disease, look for the hidden bug, look for the pathogen. It'll often be some type of bacteria, they're saying, in a hidden part of the body that hasn't been looked for. So these sorts of things can activate the immune system and create a lot of problems for people. And yet nobody really looks for causes anymore. Everybody's just too busy trying to plug up all the symptoms, which is a real shame. So let's talk about some of the triggers because we looked at the causes. So some of the triggers, there can be many different triggers. Medications can be a trigger. It's incredible how many people stay on drugs for years and years and years and expect not to develop any side effects of these drugs. But they invariably happen, particularly if you stay on antihistamine kind of drugs or allergy kind of drugs. If you stay on pain relieving drugs or acid blocking drugs, all these sort of drugs eventually will take their toll on you and you'll pay the price, which will be some type of a problem. So who knows? We could be looking at a condition that's developed from pharmaceutical drugs as well. Foods. We'll talk about foods in a subsequent video. There are many different foods that can trigger responses. So if you have got the symptoms we spoke about in an earlier video, you may want to avoid those foods. Also, we need to be careful with the amount of heat we get exposed to, the cold and the air. Is it dirty air? Is it polluted air? Is it air full of mold or toxins? Many people believe also that a rise in this mast cell syndrome it's become very relevant in the last 10 years because this was discovered in 2007, this syndrome. Now they're thinking more and more people are developing it because of pollution, because of toxins, because of stress. So there'd be a whole bunch of reasons why people can get this. And I think it's no one particular cause. I think it'll be a culmination of two or three things together along with the poor gut function that will precipitate this condition. Excuse me. If you're in doubt, get your digestive system checked out. Ask your doctor to do a comprehensive stool test for you and have a good look to see if there's no hidden inflammation in the gut. You've got no lack of beneficial bacteria. You've got lots of bad bacteria. You've got parasites. I mean, anything could be found. The gut needs cleaning up in most cases. So, I hope this was an interesting video for you and made you think a little bit about mast cell activation syndrome. Thanks for tuning in.